Hello everyone, and welcome to this series where we are going to talk about object-oriented programming concepts, design and practices. So if you remember well, in the first video, we talked about object-oriented programming concepts, concepts such as object, classes, abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, with the help of some real-life examples. Today, we will talk about design, how to design classes, how to design objects basically, and how to design relationship between classes and between objects. You remember from the first video, our problem is same. There is a tennis complex in the neighborhood, and so we wanted to create an online booking system for this tennis complex. So why do we need design basically? The only consistent thing about software is it changes. Many times clients do not know their requirements, many times technology changes, come what may, software will change. It is never going to happen like you create a software, write a web application and it's not going to change. It's always going to change. So designers and also the developers have to accommodate future changes while they are creating the present software. So keeping that in mind, you have to write your object-oriented code. You have to design your object-oriented code. To begin with, all this design philosophy is based on three things. Keep these three things in mind. Drive. Do not repeat yourself. It's one of the most important things. Why? Why would you say, what's the problem? What if I repeat it? Is it going to cost me much? Again, it comes back to this. Software changes. So imagine, you are that lazy programmer, which I was a few years back, and you don't care about this extracting out components and stuff. You just keep on duplicating the code wherever, whenever you need it, right? And now, that common piece of code exists across five different classes, five different functions, whatever, right? And now that code needs to be changed, right? Software changes. So code needs to be changed. So where do you change it? You will have to change it at all five places where you have replicated it, where you have duplicated that code. Instead, if you would have extracted the code out and kept it in a single module, you will have to change it only at one place. Divide and conquer. Whenever you see your files are getting bigger and bigger, bulkier and bulkier in code, think on divide and conquer. Right, and these all things are driven by one thing, that is change. Software is going to change. You're going to add more code. You're going to add more functionality. You're going to remove some functionality, add something new. So accordingly, you have to make your coding habits, design habits like that. They should be able to accommodate the change without destroying the existing working functionality. Okay, so on those lines, let's study or let's discuss some guidelines called as solid principles for object-oriented modeling or design. So the first principle or the first guideline says that this is S, which stands for single responsibility principle. So what is single responsibility principle? The textual rule or textual guideline is a class should have one and only one reason to change. So, I mean, how do you infer that? Is it like a class should have only one reason or only one time it should change? No, it can have multiple reasons to change. It could be changed multiple times across time. But we are talking about context. For example, let's take an example of Sachin Tendulkar. Now, when Sachin Tendulkar retired, right, so he talked about the much bigger role played by his wife, played by his family, that enabled him to excel in his sport for such a long span of time. So, what did his wife do so well across his career? So, his wife took care of all the other matters, all the other family matters, all the other living matters for Sachin. So, in Sachin's life, single responsibility principle was Sachin's performance on the field should only and only vary because of creating reasons, because of sporting reasons. Are you getting it? The single responsibility principle for Sachin would be performances of Sachin should only vary because of sporting reasons, not because there is a scarcity of water in Mumbai or Sachin has been made the president of the housing society where he lives and he has to go to municipality every day or whatever. I mean, no, imagine that happening. Your class should change for one and only one reason. One reason is contextual reason. For example, I'll give you now a technical example. So let's again talk about our tennis complex software that we are going to design. So what is that one class that we must create?
Member.
Yes, member or user, right? So the members who are going to play the tennis, right? So when I start designing this member class, right? So let's say this is my member class. What should I put? What kind of code should go in this member class? What can this member do? This member could be registered in the system. This member can book the court, tennis court. This member can cancel membership. This member can, you know what? This member could be notified with the offer, some new offer or, you know, booking confirmation or something like that. But in this member class, what should we put? Shall I put a code called as make booking? Shall I put a code like that in this member class? What do you think? Why should not we put this here?
Because you told that the class should be care about the single responsibility and it's not related with the member. Member should have only the CRUD operation from my point of view.
Exactly. So he's right in the sense that we could have a special class, a separate class called as booking, which is looking after the functionality of booking. It is not the responsibility of member class to do the booking. It is a specialized duty of booking class. So member should have functions like create, read, update, delete. Let's say creation of member. So there are certain rules right now for creating a member, right? So they are mentioned in this create member function, in this member class. Tomorrow, the organization or the tennis complex decides to change those rules. That now we have certain different requirements for registering new members. So only that change in functionality should drive change in member class. Let's say tomorrow you decide to do changes in booking rules. So they should change the booking class. They should not change the member class. Are you getting it? That's why we are saying single responsibility principle. It is easy to maintain and change software when you maintain the context correct. Context of this class is about activities about members. Context of this class is about activities regarding booking. So you have to divide your logic like that. Let's now talk about the second principle, that is O, which stands for open for extension and closed for modification. Example, right? So there are two ways to treat this hair loss problems. First, you do hair transplant, which is against the principle of open for extension, closed for modification. So what do they do in hair transplant is they take back the hairs from the back side and they put it somewhere on the front side where you have lost hairs, right? So I guess that is contrary to this principle, right? And the second way of treating hair loss problems is hair weaving, like this fella here. So what do? They do not touch their existing hairs and they add some new hairs like this. They extend their hairs, right, to look normal, amazing, I guess. That is open for extension but closed for modification. So this is fella is the best example. Or this fella, That was the example, real life example. Let's go to the technical example now. We talk about online code booking. Obviously, there will be payment involved of some kind, right? So there are two ways we can code this. We can say, we can write a class, payment, right? What kind of payment can we have?
Online payment, with card payment, or we can go cash payment.
Exactly, we have plenty of options, right? If P dot type equal to cash, write some cash logic. If P dot type equal to card, then do some equal to card, then do some card logic. The problem with this code is that, yeah, obviously it will work. There's no problem. What if tomorrow there's another method of payment? There's new method of payment. You never know. World is constantly changing. Let's say barter payment system, right? So how do you accommodate that? So you will add one more if else letter. If p dot type payment dot type, if payment dot type equal to barter, if payment dot type equal to Paytm or some kind of wallet, online there are wallets, right? Different kinds of wallets. So in order to accommodate that change, will you change your logic all the time? No, that's not the correct way. Again, you can end up making some mistake in here, syntactical mistake, and the product is already live, right? And it can end up costing you severe damage in your business, right? So the best way to do this is follow open for extension and closed for modification. So that is, instead of creating a concrete payment class, you create an interface called as iPayment, right? iPayment interface has one method, that is make payment, right? This make payment method, this interface then will be implemented by different kinds of classes such as cash payment, right? Then card payment. Then let's say wallet payment, right? And this, all these classes which are implementing this interface will provide their own implementation of make payment method. So for cash payment, make payment logic will be different. For card payment, make payment logic will be different. For wallet payment, it will be different. And here in the booking class, we'll not bother about that. We'll just say make payment and some instance of iPayment. And just call p dot make payment. Right? So advantage with this approach, let's say tomorrow there is a new way of payment that we want to introduce. Barter payment. We'll just write one more class, right? Barter payment. And it will override, it will implement this method in some another manner, another way, and we should be able to get it functional without changing the existing code, without breaking the existing logic, without causing unnecessary errors or bugs in production environment. So this is one more example of principle of open for extension, closed for modification.